God, Brother Rocco.
Hey, buddy, it's me. How you guys doing? Doing okay? Allergies are kicking my butt. Work's busy, but surviving. Just a little update. Things have been slow, but I've got my chassis work done on the Chevy Cheeseburger Tribute Build. It's the 2003 Chevy SSR. Grab you, give you a look. So I've got it lowered down just about as low as I want to go. I think it's still decently low enough because the ride height on this stock was extremely goofy looking. So I think this looks a tad bit better, a little more hot rod-ish that as to what I think Chevy was going for when they started producing this vehicle. So that's that. Be right back and I'll show you the chassis work. Alright guys, I'm going to show you first what I cut out of the kit. Truck bed pan, the front left and right fenders, rear left and right fenders, front left and right fenders, left and right frame pieces, frame cross member, part of the fuel tank, and fuel tank support. Here's the fuel tank. The piece I had to cut out was because of interference with lowering the kit into the differential. Frame pieces, had to notch that to raise that up. Shaped in pretty nicely. Relocated the shock mount left and right. Four-link suspension. Of course, you raised that and the kit piece did not line up correctly, so I had to make new link brackets, upper and lower, and relocate that. Move around to the front. Sorry about moving this around so much. I shortened up the coilovers and had to cut the A-arms, the lower A-arms, in three places. I didn't completely cut them, I just notched them enough to where I could bend it into position and glue it. So I wanted to keep as much of this kit original parts as I possibly could, and besides making new A-arms and whatever else, that was the easiest thing for me. It took a little bit of time, I just went slow, shaved a little, glued it, let it set, test fit it, shaved a little more, glued it, let it set, test fitted it. It came out pretty good. As you can see, it looks pretty much all original kit pieces. Here's another look at the rear four link. And I also had to add spacers above the coilovers because those weren't long enough. And hello again. I was going to show you the motor. Well, I've got pictures. I'll give a picture. The motor, the engine is very detailed. It's really nice. It'd be if you're not into this truck body, for the suspension parts alone and the motor, the seats are very nice. It'd be a good parts kit. And it doesn't seem to be pretty popular. I don't think I've seen anybody build one of these. But it's a really nice kit. Really detailed. There's going to be a little bit of a fitment issue on the rear bumper, I want to call it, or the rear fascia piece. It's open too far, so I'm going to have to glue it and hold those sides in, which isn't a big deal. And something else I did, battery issues, sorry guys. Forgot what I was going to say. So, that's about it. Before my batteries die again. So everybody keep building. Thank you subscribers. For the guys that have already finished their Chevy Tribute build. Nice job. I've seen a few of them. Everything's just going off. So you guys take care. Thanks again. Once I get my other batteries charged up, I'm probably going to do another video this weekend. I got to get some paint on this. And then take care. I guess you have to have a problem if you want to invent a contraption. First you cause a train wreck, then they put me in traction. Well, first came an action and then a reaction, but you can't switch around for your own satisfaction. Well, you burnt my house down then got mad at my reaction. The effect and make it the cause. No, well, you can't take the effect and make it the cause. I didn't rob a bank because you made up the law. Blame me for robbing Peter, but don't you blame Paul. Can't take the effect and make it the cause.